Our first story, there is an uneasy calm in the Yolokrobo traditional area following the exhumation of the body of the late chief of the area, Nene Nadaute. The tomb of the late chief was broken into in March, and his body and other precious ornaments used to bury him were also stolen. The Ologo and Akrobeto gates of the area are suspecting the current chief, who they say is ineligible to mount the throne, and he has been responsible and suspected to be involved in the exhumation.
The new chief, Nene Nwe Anoba, ascended the throne in February and has received little support from the natives of the traditional area, who have constantly demanded the chief steps down. Some residents of the area are protesting against the chief and King George. A sub chief says if the necessary steps are not taken, the situation will degenerate.
We don't know where our paramount chief is now. So the boys are very wide awake. The whole Yolokrobo is sitting on a time bomb. Whoever is hearing me must know. We will not sit down. For somebody, we don't know his paternal home, to come and vandalize our palace, install himself as a colonel. From where? We have only two gates. We will fight it to the last atom of our blood.
King George added, the new chief has no lineage and has no right to ascend the throne, and suspect him of being the mastermind of the exhumation.
All that they are doing is an abomination to the customary rites of Yolokrobo. Now, after the police have installed him and left, he now went in, brought in grave looters. So when he brought them in, all that we heard was he was not sleeping in the house. Why? The ghost of the late Kuno had been haunting him in the house. So in order for the ghost to stop haunting him, some marabouts were brought in, whether they were from Mali or wherever it is, and then they started planting charms in the palace and around the palace, only for us to hear later that the tomb of the late Kono has been vandalized.
Fort Koko Daute, elder sister of the late chief, says the act is sacrilegious and has warned of serious ramification if her brother's body is not returned.
Calamity on the community.
Very, very.
How is that going to happen? And
we are going to find out. They should bring him back. And there will be trouble if they don't take care. It's a serious matter, and we have never witnessed such a thing in this Yilo. Now, if you are coming as a chief, your successor, should be, the body should be taken away. For what? Ritual success or what? So there was going to be a trouble.
The new chief, Nene Nwe Anoba II, who hails from the third gate, says the stool will respond to the allegations at the appropriate time.
The Inspector General of Police, Mohammed Al Hassan, has assured residents of Wa that the police will work assiduously to curb the increasing crime rate in the municipality. Speaking in Wa shortly after he arrived to join the police night patrol team, the IGP said his men are very serious about the tax ahead, and the police were up to the tax and will do everything possible to bring criminals to book. We bring a report by Rafiq Salam from Wa.
The IGP, a couple of weeks ago, increased the staff strength of the Wa police. Due to this, dozens of suspected criminals in the municipality were arrested. But this has not reduced crime. The IGP visit was to boost the morale of the police to fight crime. He told the police not to shield criminals, but expose them.
Policing is done out on the streets. Policing is all about patrols. It's not about officers. So, for me, I thought I was on a normal duty. I believe leadership is always by example. And my presence during the patrol, I believe, only encourage the young ones, the officers, to also do the same and make sure that 70% of our policing time is spent outside the offices, on the streets, in the communities, you know, so that we can deter criminality and also reassure members of the public of the presence, our presence, and that if they are in need, they know where we can get the police immediately.
He later joined the night patrol team to move to suspected criminals' hideouts. The IGP and his team also visited some police checkpoints at Kambali, Baguri, and Mangu, and inspected some of the gadgets used in the operations. It was revealed that some of the weapons and torchlights used were obsolete and malfunctioning. Later in an interview, the IGP promised to equip personnel with tools to fight crime.
I'm here. I'm happy you are ready. And I believe tonight we will all be on the ground to make sure that as we go along, we will be picking up the lessons, we will be picking up areas that we think we should re-strategize, reposition our, you know, various operational elements, our various logistics, and so on and so forth.
Rafiq Salam's report from WA.
Away from the subject of the police and senior staff members of the Bulk Oil Storage Transportation Limited, BOST, are up in arms against management of the firm. The staff accused management of violating the firm's recruitment policy. In a strongly worded petition addressed to the company's board and cited by Joy News, the workers demanded the immediate suspension of an ongoing restructuring exercise. Here is a news desk report.
In the petition dated March 2015, the workers say there is, quote, a deliberate violation of the labor law by the company with regards to temporary staff who have been under contract for more than 4 years. They question why workers who have been appraised, evaluated and recommended for permanent employment by heads of departments are yet to be confirmed. Again, they accuse management of what they described as closed-door recruitment of new staff without regards for the ongoing restructuring process. The senior staff say, while workers have been asked to reapply for their existing jobs, new staff are being employed every now and then. This, they say, is contrary to laid-down recruitment processes. They cite an example of the company's treasury officer who has been working with BOST for 9 years. According to them, she was dismissed under, quote, bizarre circumstances without considering her career development. The strongly worded petition concludes by making 7 key demands, including the suspension of the restructuring process and providing better clarity on the procedure. The association is also asking the board to revoke all new appointments that may have been done illegally.
The president of Ashesi University, Dr. Patrick Iwa, has reiterated calls for government and educational stakeholders to improve the quality of education in the country, right from the primary level to university. Speaking on the sidelines of an entrepreneurial and motivational program for youth organized by TEDx Accra, Dr. Patrick Iwa indicated that the country needs to step up the quality of teaching and learning in schools to enable graduates to compete effectively on the job market.
We need to have the fundamentals right. I think that the government has been focused on getting access to education, so getting kids in school, not as focused on quality. And so we see in the primary school system, especially the public primary school system, that there's very low quality. There needs to be a renewed energy around quality. I don't hear enough talk about quality in the political discourse. And I think we will start to see a change in quality when the political leaders, political parties start to talk more about quality and start to demand that students and kids who go to the public schools deserve to have a higher quality education. I also think that Ghana can learn from the examples of countries such as Senegal, Cape Verde, Ivory Coast, where the government funds students to go to private universities. So in Senegal, for example, the government sees all Senegalese citizens as important, whether they're going to a public university or a private university. If they go to a private university, the government pays half the fees for them, and then they have to find the rest of their fees, or the school has to give them financial aid. But I think that kind of activity would improve access to quality education.
But as always, if you are interested in a lot more updates from our social network pages, this is the page. On Facebook, we have Joy News on TV, and we also have, interestingly, a handle on Twitter. We have Joy News on TV. Okay, so please also make sure you log on to the news portal, myjoyonline.com, for a lot more news updates. That's it for the news. Again, brought to you by Coca-Cola. AM News.